corner and turning across the bend, I see a little gate, it's to my farmyard friend. A little farm called Ivydale, where I like to go. Will you come with me? I'll show you what I know. Yes, I'm going round the corner, up across the glen. I'm going to see my moo cow and his farmyard friends. There's Bunny Quack and Lammy and Bessie and the hens, and I'm gonna spend my bedtime with them. And so to bed they say, and so to bed. So to bed, so to bed, so to bed. And so to bed they say, and so to bed. So to bed, so to bed, so to bed.
Oh, hello. I'm Helen. This is Moo Cow. And it's nearly time for bed. Are you ready? Come with me. It's bath time and Moo Cow is having a bath, aren't you, Moo Cow? Now when we have a bath we like to, that's right, wash our face. This is the way we wash our face, wash our face, wash our face. This is the way we wash our face in the bath at bedtime. What else shall we wash today? Well, everything really, but yes, your ears. This is the way we wash our ears, wash our ears, wash our ears. This is the way we wash our ears in the bath at bedtime. Maybe under our arms. This is the way we wash under our arms, wash under our arms, wash under our arms. This is the way we wash under our arms in the bath at bedtime. Now, what else do we do in the bath? That's right, we mustn't forget to brush your teeth. We like to brush our teeth in the bath, don't we, Moo Cow? This is the way we brush our teeth, brush our teeth, brush our teeth. This is the way we brush our teeth in the bath at bedtime. Beautiful pearly whites. White teeth, black and white cow. We had a quite stripy flannel today. We're going to sing songs about colour and the rainbow, aren't we, Moo Cow?
Red and yellow and pink and green, purple and orange and blue. I can sing a rainbow, too. Listen with your eyes, listen with your eyes, and sing everything you see. You can sing a rainbow, sing along with me. Red and yellow and pink and green, purple and orange and blue. Now we can sing a rainbow, too. Yes, we can sing a rainbow, too.
That was fun, wasn't it? So, Moo Cow, tell me, what did you do today? Right, we better check it out.
That's lovely. Good. Well done. Can you put the lid on, please? I think that's enough.
Nice.
Right, enough. Enough. Good boy, put the lid on, please.
In a minute, when you've done some nice patterns, I'm going to give you a piece of paper to take a print. Okay? Just wait.
Look at my hand. There, a monster hand.
Rosie, if you lift it up now. Oh, nice, Rosie. Ooh, now lift it up and see what's on the other side. Lift it up, Stefano. Peel it up. Wow. And then give it to Sandy. Lovely. Bring it here and we'll hang it up. Rosie, bring it here very carefully.
Little big green monster.
You come and do it yourself. Where are you going?
Eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. And eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. Shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. And eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's lovely. Lovely, well done. Oh, it's story time, yes, it's story time. I'm wishing that we really had some more time. Yes, it's story time, oh, it's story time too. I want to tell a story with you, yes, I do. I want to tell a story with you. Cause it's story time, yes, it's story time. If I sing it anymore, I'll have no more time. Cause it's story time, yes, it's story time too. So come and have a story with me and my friends. Come and have a story with me that never ends. Come and have a story with me. Moo Cow and me, Moo Cow and me.
Hello, I'm Grandpa Simon, and I'm telling the McMouse Tales.
The McMouse Tales! Yeah. The McMouse Tales!
This one's called Escape from London.
Escape from London! Yay!
Mr. and Mrs. McMouse were two Scottish mice who, quite by accident, had travelled to London in a suitcase. As you might imagine, London seemed like a marvellous city to the two country mice. They met mice from all over the world and ate from the bins of all the best restaurants in London. Such a treat. But after several weeks of the high life, they grew homesick for the quiet breezes over Highland heather. They missed the peacefulness, their mouse friends, but most of all they missed their own little cottage called Caledoony, the house under the little hill, which has beautiful views of the mountains and forests all around. "Mr. McMouse," said his wife one evening, as they sat on a balcony overlooking London, "let's go home."
"Why, yes, my dear, but how?" asked Mr. McMouse.
"Oh, surely you can think of something."
"Think of what?" came a voice behind them. It was Johnny, their Cockney mouse friend, who lived in a fine hotel nearby and had shown them around London when they first arrived.
"How can we return to Scotland?" asked Mr. McMouse sadly.
"I can think of it easy," boasted Johnny. "Bloke in room 22 is heading up tonight. You could hitch a lift in his suitcase."
Mr. McMouse looked excited, but Mrs. McMouse was unsure.
"What if we get in the wrong suitcase?" she asked.
But Johnny and Mr. McMouse had already dashed off. Mrs. McMouse followed breathlessly as they were led through the hotel. Johnny took them straight to room 22. It was empty, but there was a suitcase standing open.
"Quick," called Johnny, "footsteps."
They leapt in and hid under some Bermuda shorts and Hawaiian shirts. Mrs. McMouse couldn't help but feel that something wasn't quite right about those shorts and shirts.
"Hang on," thought Mrs. McMouse. "No one goes to Scotland packed like this."
Then she noticed a holiday brochure with palm trees on it and the word Bermuda
written across in fancy writing.
"This is the wrong suitcase," she cried.
But before they could leap out again, the suitcase lid closed and the lock snapped shut quick. Then, whoosh, it was carried to a taxi. At least that's what they guessed. It's hard to know inside a suitcase. Away they went, bound for Bermuda, or so they thought.
"Oh, Mr. McMouse, when will you stop getting us into trouble?" exclaimed his wife,
and they clung to each other in fright. But just as the suitcase was lifted out of the taxi, it fell open. Out they spilled with a pair of sandals and some holiday brochures.
"Ah, mice!" screamed a woman, jumping into the air.
"Run!" shouted Mr. McMouse. They dashed away, luckily, right into Euston Station. And there, in front of them, was the great sleeper train, the Caledonian Express, bound for Inverness.
"Quick, my dear," said Mr. McMouse.
They leapt in at the door and found themselves in a comfortable baggage hold. Soon the train chugged out of the station. They could scarcely believe their good fortune. But as Mrs. McMouse scurried about making a bed for them, she knocked over a silvery-looking pewter plate, which was balanced on top of a pile of suitcases in the corner. It bounced twice as it hit the floor, and the pewter plate bended, and my stories ended.
Hello, it's bedtime, and Moo Cow is going to bed, aren't you, Moo Cow? And I thought we would sing him a lullaby to help him get to sleep. Would you like to help me sing a lullaby? A song to help Moo Cow get to sleep? Okay.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. I woke up in Jordan, what did I see? Coming for to carry me home. A band of angels coming after me, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. If you get to heaven before I do, coming for to carry me home, be sure to tell them I'm coming on through, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me.
Night, night, Moo Cow. Far beyond the stars, far beyond the stars, Love is watching over us, far beyond the stars.
Squidgy blobs of red and green, dots of orange in between. Then my bath, and then to bed. Dream of orange, green, and red. Beyond the stars, beyond the stars. Love is always watching us, far beyond the stars.
And so to bed they go, and so to bed. So to bed, so to bed, so to bed. And so to bed they go, and so to bed. So to bed, so to bed, so to bed.